This clip was made using the distilled model from Lightrix. If you are into image generation with an 8GB or 12GB card, you will know that the generation time for the images is around 50 seconds to a minute. These clips were generated within that time frame. Details about the distilled model are available in the LTX Comfy UI repository. This section describes the LTX 13 billion model we saw in the previous video. Later, on the 14th, the distilled version of the 13 billion model was released. The first point discusses the original model, which can generate videos in just 8 steps. The size of this model is around 28 gigabytes, making it impractical for a standard desktop computer. Below is the 13 billion quantized model. I will be using this model because it is suitable for consumer-grade hardware, like this flagship card. While I do not have one of these cards, my 16GB card can handle it. There is also a GGUF version of this distilled model that I will be showing later in the video. Cards with memory sizes of 8 or 12 gigabytes can utilize the GGUF models. It states that to achieve the best performance, I need to install the Q8 kernel package. Setting up this package is a bit complicated, and I prefer to keep the video simple, so I will skip this and set up the workflow without it. Here is the model, which is around 16 gigabytes. It's an FP8 model. Below is an example workflow for distilled models. I came across some videos on YouTube as recommendations related to the LTX video. In the video, the presenter mentioned providing the workflow to their viewers for free on their personal network. And to access the workflow, he wanted the viewers to join his network. However, the real credit should go to the team maintaining this GitHub repository. This distilled image-to-video workflow is designed for the larger 28GB model. I need the quantized FP8 workflow, and this should be the one. Workflow for the FP8 model. I will copy the workflow and paste it into the Comfy UI, which opens in a new tab. The workflow I saw in the YouTube video was similar to this, with some minor changes. So just be aware that these are free and owned by the project owner. This is where the video upscaling begins, but upscaling takes time. The LTX distilled model for video generation has come a long way, making it faster compared to what we saw in my LTX video from 4 months ago. The upscaling model needs to be further refined and tuned to improve speed. Therefore, I will not be covering upscaling for now. Let's wait for a few more months. The workflow we are examining can be a bit overwhelming for some viewers, so I created a test workflow that is similar to the previous video. I have removed some of the nodes and tried making it look simpler. I suggest watching the previous video, specifically the part where I was creating the workflow, as it is straightforward. If we look at the previous workflow, the clip node was for the GGUF model, which has been modified in the new workflow. The checkpoint and VAE nodes were separate in the previous workflow. Now they are combined into one node that provides both connections. The last difference is with this node, which now takes some float values. In programming, this decimal representation of numbers is referred as a float. Some custom nodes, such as the Comfy UI LTX video, will be required. I demonstrated the installation in the previous video. The Comfy UI KJ node is also necessary, along with the video helper suite. You will need the GGUF node for GGUF models, which I covered in the previous video. Let's take a look at the simplified workflow. I will link this workflow in the description. The 16GB quantized model we discussed must be downloaded and saved inside the Comfy UI's model folder, specifically in the checkpoint folder. The model and VAE connection have been derived from the same 16GB file. Additionally, the clip text encoder is included here. I took the file from Hugging Face, uploaded by Comfy.org. These are the two files. The FP16 version is larger, so download it if you have a 16GB card. Alternatively, try the smaller version if you encounter a memory error. I am using the larger FP16 file. Next is the prompt. This negative prompt is the same from the previous video. Above that, the positive prompt for generating these AI clips is from this black box AI. I am using the free version, and it works well. The remaining settings are taken from the example workflow I found on GitHub. This image here is from a previous video, and I will change it. Make sure to change the seed if it is fixed. The video resolution is managed from this section. I created 240 frames, and it automatically adds one extra frame. At 24 frames per second, these 241 frames will yield a 10-second video. These settings are kept similar to those in the example workflow. Click Run to queue the workflow for processing. This 16GB model requires the entire VRAM, but the GGUF model should work on lower memory cards. However, note that it will not be as fast as the 16GB model. It took 120 seconds to generate a 10-second video, and you can see that the previous two videos were also generated within 2 minutes. This text-to-video generation looks fine but may not be very realistic, or perhaps the prompt needs improvement. The results are acceptable, considering that they were generated within 2 minutes. I used an image for the image-to-video generation and made sure to resize the image to around 700 pixels, which should be manageable for my graphics card. I then uploaded the image and matched the video resolution to the image size for the best result. I took a prompt from Blackbox AI, which describes an innocent creature with a Pixar-like charm and a camera orbiting around it. Connect the image node, ensuring that the optional conditional indices have a value of 0. In programming, numbering starts at 0. In this workflow, 0 refers to the first image provided by the node. I will click Run to process the workflow. It took around 3 minutes, and I received the result. The result looks good, but the camera was supposed to be orbiting around the creature, which did not happen. I changed the seed, increasing it by 1, and queued the workflow again with the same prompt. What do you think of the result? Creating perfect fingers is still a challenge. But if we set aside these minor mistakes, based on the current level of progress, these results are impressive. Try experimenting with prompts using GPT-like services. You will achieve some great results. Due to the short generation time, you can always obtain multiple results and have the opportunity to select the best one. I tested a realistic image with a prompt. A cat walking in a stream slowly, creating ripples around its paws. I queued the workflow multiple times by repeatedly hitting the run button. In 15 minutes, I received the results, and some of them were impressive. The water ripples appeared realistic, however, the physics behind them seemed to be lacking. In this clip, the cat's legs aren't moving, yet the ripples remain consistent. For graphic cards with low VRAM, consider using the GGUF models. Search for the LTX 13 billion distilled GGUF. I will share the link in the description. The GGUF models range from Q3 to Q8, and you can choose any of these based on the graphics memory in your system. The workflow is similar to the previous GGUF workflow, so I will retrieve it from the video description. You can download or copy the content and paste it into the Comfy UI, which should open in a new tab. I referred to the README file in the repository. It says the clip loader file is similar to the one we saw in the previous video. The UNET file will be the distilled GGUF model. I have downloaded the Q4 and Q8 files. The VAE is also similar to the one I demonstrated in the previous video. Links to the files will be provided in the description. For a quick demo, I will select the Q8 file for UNet and its respective clip loader. I will be using the same prompt and image. The goal here is to evaluate the video generation time, performance, and quality of the results. The usage seems to be similar to the standard 13 billion model, but I am using the larger Q8 model. The time taken to generate the video is almost the same as the standard 13 billion model shown in the previous video. It took 350 seconds to generate 97 frames, resulting in a 4-second clip, and I was not satisfied with the outcome. After a few attempts, I achieved some decent results, considering the challenge of using an incorrectly sized image for a landscape result. This process is not as fast as the quantized distilled model we saw earlier, but it can still produce good results. I will share the GGUF workflow in the description, and if you are using it, I recommend watching the previous video where I demonstrated the installed nodes in my Comfy UI Manager.